marvellous new car. Can you tell us a little bit about your new car,
Andrew? Oh, yes, it's pleasure. Thank you very much. Good afternoon. This car is built and designed here in Mexico. We are introducing it in and the main reason is this is the natural map of the car. Britain has excellent fans, people that know and people that love driving styles. That's the reason that we have the performance and we will be able to satisfy this very demanding market.
And this is the first time this car has been seen in this country in the right-hand drive.
Yes, the fact we had shown a previous car, this is already the complete car of Britain, so it's right-hand drive. And additionally, it has aero package. That is the first variation we have in basic car. It has a front end speaker, increased cooling, and a rear bumper. But the base car, as it is a very good platform for driving and for track days. And so we have to take advantage, we want to take advantage of this good base we have, lower car, good power to weight ratio, great weight distribution. So the aero package is a great component.
And in terms of the construction, you're using carbon fiber and bonded aluminium rather than rivets, so you've really aggressively made it as light as possible.
Yes, sir. The chassis is extruded aluminium, sheet aluminium, CNC cut. Then we have the carbon fiber floor. And we use extensively the best structural bonding. Then we have front end crash structure, rear end steel subframe for the engine and suspension, and then the body is fiberglass.
And the production car will have a Ford EcoBoost engine going on.
Right. We have now the development of the standard EcoBoost engine. We're happy for that because this is a late generation engine, very good, very clean, great emissions, the power is there, and the reliability of course is there, so it's a great engine for a car like this. Also, we have the possibility of getting spare parts, everything easy for the customer.
So, you're designing and building the car in Mexico. Where is the development taking place? Where are you testing it? Do you have access to any racetracks, or have you been testing it on the road?
Oh yes, Mexico is a good tradition in racing. Of course, not the tradition of England, but we have good tracks. We have an excellent test track close to our facility. We are close to this facility, about 4 miles away. But then we also tested on the hard, difficult conditions of the Mexico roads. You see, you have speed bumps all the time, poles. There are very good roads, but then you find some very, very extremely hard conditions on some roads that make an excellent testing ground for the car.
Well, getting it ready for Britain's roads, which many of our roads aren't very good at all.
But anyway, the conditions in Mexico are generally more difficult in the roads. There are good roads, but the testing ground is harder, much harder than here. So we designed the suspension of the car, for example, around those conditions. So it's an extra guarantee for the customer if the car is compact.
Which of the established manufacturers' cars do you see as the main rivals? Is it going to be the Lotus Elise?
Well, the Lotus is a natural comparison because it's our car has the same layout. We is slightly longer, but it's close. Size is about the same. So it's a natural relay. You say where you relate in very fast to that. Then we have other sports cars that are already in the market, but in this layout, it's not very easy to find a car. I mean, mid-engine, 54-46% weight distribution, closer to reality to zero, then you bring the options to very few options. And this, as all fans we know, is the best layout for high performance driving. And that, and there, the next option is maybe much more expensive.
And another question that people will want to hear is where will they be able to buy these cars, and how much will they cost?
Well, we are one of the important things that we are doing is to certify, finalize the certification process, which is going fine. So that we complete it and then it becomes a fully certified car. And then, more important is to have service for the customer, and for that we are relying on Lux Final Body, which is a company specialized in this kind of cars. We take care of the service and sales and promotion of the car.
When do you expect to officially launch the car?
We will start the sales in the third quarter of the year, after we finish the process certification and we introduce it properly to the market.
And the price will be similar to, say, the Lotus Elise?
We won't be competitive. Yes, we won't be competitive. We know that we have to offer the best price we can. And we are close to, after we finalize some of the tax and certification, to keep the final figure.
And you know, your car is here with the Mercedes-Benz AMG Black Edition, the new Ferrari V12. How pleased have you been with the response from people at the show to your car? Because it's kind of been the center of attention, hasn't it?
Well, we are very happy. We think the response of such a demanding and knowledgeable public is a big boost and a big responsibility. But yes, being in this company is a big responsibility. These are heavyweight marks. What can I say about this marks? Everything is said and told that being here with them is an honor. Our car stand is an honor for us, and it's a boost to our confidence.
Well, we really appreciate you lending the car to us and showing it off here at the Auto Sports Show. Daniel Mastretta, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.